who join us here in the Chapel of St. Peter and Paul. Today, we observe the 22nd Sunday in Ordinary Time. Please take a moment now to silence your cell phone and other electronic devices. Our celebrant this evening is Father John Gomez. Please stand and join in our opening hymn.
Thank you. us what is good, and by your watchful care keep safe what you have nurtured. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Please.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. You duped me, O Lord, and I let myself be duped. You were too strong for me, and you triumphed. All the day I am an object of laughter. Everyone mocks me. Whenever I speak, I must cry out. Violence and outrage is my message. The word of the Lord has brought me derision and reproach all the day. I say to myself, I will not mention him. I will speak in his name no more. But then it becomes like fire burning in my heart, imprisoned in my bones. I grow weary holding it in. I cannot endure it. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. I urge you, brothers and sisters, by the mercies of God, to offer your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and pleasing to God, your spiritual worship. Do not conform yourselves to this age, but be transformed by the renewal of your mind, that you may discern what is the will of God, what is good and pleasing and perfect. The Word of the Lord.
Something. Jeremiah, the prophet, one of the great prophets, also was called by God. And it happened in year 627 before Christ. 627 before Christ, the Lord called Jeremiah. If you want to read about it, Jeremiah 1:1, the call of the prophet. The people, after a while, so he went did his work as a prophet. But a little later, he found that the people did not want to listen to him anymore, because he started announcing the corruption of Israel, the corruption of the king, and the corruption of the office of the king, the kingship. He announced and lived himself the first deportation, exile to Babylon in year 598. So he was a very unpopular prophet, and people did not want to listen to him. Jerusalem was taken, and the temple, the great temple of God that was built, was destroyed. And Jeremiah had to go through that. So people lost their hope. People was losing their faith. Looking at this, even the temple of God destroyed. People did not want to listen to the prophet, even though the voice of the prophet was the only standing voice for Israel in God's name. No priests, no judges, no elders, nobody had the authority, no king, only the prophets. But even the people did not want to listen. This is the context in which we just listen the first reading from Jeremiah. Jeremiah, in his humanity, feel that he did not want to do anymore this job. He did not want to be anymore a prophet. He did not want to announce anymore, because he said, nobody listened to me. And what I told them happened, and they are rejecting me. So I will not name or mention the name of God again. And I will not be a prophet anymore. So he wanted to quit, stop working. But then fire was in his heart, in his chest, and in his mind, so strong that he could not hold to it. He could not resist it. And he went to pray. And then, once again, by God's grace, very special way for his prophet, for Jeremiah, Jeremiah came to understand that he needed to be a prophet, that God was calling to be a prophet, especially at that very moment, especially during the difficulties, especially when they were in exile, when there were no temple, when God needed to be listened, when God needed to be there with the people through the prophet. And he did. So he went back to his vocation, he went back to his job, and he kept doing his job all the way, the rest of his life. And he did the best he could as a prophet, and as a human being, he fulfilled God's plan, God's will. Him. Jesus Christ came, and he was very intentional, very clear about that we, like Jeremiah did 6 centuries before Christ, that we, all of us, are called to do God's plans, God's will in our own lives. We just listened to the gospel today, Matthew chapter 16, 21 to 27. Verses. It is a continuation from last weekend's gospel, which was Matthew 16, 13 to 20. It is one unit, one passage that we have in 2 Sundays. Last weekend the Lord asked in the gospel we listen, or the first part of this gospel, the Lord asked to the disciples, who the people say that I am? And then he asked them, but you, who do you say that I am? And of course, as we listened last week, Peter said, you are the Christ, the Son of the living God. Immediately the Lord responded, and you appeared. And upon this rock I will build my church. You are Peter. You are the rock. And I will build my church upon the rock. But today, in the second part of this gospel, the Lord said, I'm going to Jerusalem. And every time the Lord says, I'm going to Jerusalem, he means, I'm going to take the cross. I'm going to suffer. I'm going to suffer, to be killed, and I will be raised. And Peter, the same Peter that said last week, you are the Christ, the Son of the living God, said, no, Lord, you cannot go. How can this happen? Please, no. You are the rock, the Lord says. But today, the Lord says, get behind me, Satan, because you are thinking like a human being, not like God. The same Peter, the same Lord, the same dialogue, in the same passage. Of course, Peter was thinking like a human being, and the Lord had the experience in the desert when he was there, the temptations, the three temptations that he had, and the Lord said to the devil, get behind me, Satan. I came to do God's will, my Father's will, and I will do it. My brothers and sisters, every disciple could deny the Lord sometimes. It could happen. It happened to Peter. I do not know him. No, I don't. I do not know him. It happened to the poor Peter. Of course, the Lord came and redeemed Peter. But it is very easy for a human person, like happened to Peter, or like it happened to Thomas, or like it happened to James and John, who wanted to sit to the right and the left of Jesus and be in God's kingdom next to him, to everyone. We could have those temptations that Peter had to avoid the cross, to avoid following the Lord and following God's plan. The Lord speaks about denying, saving, and losing our lives. A paradox. To save one's life, one must lose it or lose it. The Lord is calling us, my brothers and sisters, today in the gospel, like he called Peter, like he called Thomas, like he called John and James and all his disciples and all his apostles, to go with him to Jerusalem, to the cross. The Lord is calling us today to go with him to Jerusalem, to suffer, to take the cross, to be faithful, and to endure whatever we have to endure in order to be with him in our humanity. Sometimes we think only like human beings, but we are invited, like the Lord invited Peter, to think like God does, meaning to do God's will in our lives. We are called today in our own lives, August 2020, to follow the Lord's will in our reality, in our humanity. We also could be like Jeremiah in the first reading, who do not want to do what God is calling us to do. Sometimes we want to just quit being disciples of the Lord, perhaps, like Jeremiah did. But the Lord is giving us the grace, as he called Jeremiah and gave the grace to Jeremiah and called him back again to the mission. The Lord always, always call us back to the mission, call us back to do his will. for the salvation of all. It is not only for our salvation, it is for the salvation of all that he came, that he founded the church upon the rock. And he held Peter, today Francis, to guide the church through the difficulties. Today we pray for Francis, as the disciples pray for Peter and the other apostles, so that they may guide us in the unity and peace that we need in the church, in order to keep working for the salvation of all, for our own salvation. Offering our bodies like living sacrifice, as Paul says in the second reading. My brothers and sisters, may God bless you, may God bless us, and may we always stay away from any temptation, so that we always do God's will, not only for ourselves, but for the salvation of all, for our brothers and sisters, for the whole church. May God bless us always to be good disciples today. Praise be Jesus Christ, now and forever.
Silent
pray to the Lord.
Lord,
for the end of the pandemic, we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
Heavenly Father, listen to our prayers and help us always to be good disciples of our Lord Jesus Christ, taking our own cross. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Please.
Thank you.
Therefore, O Lord, we remember you by your same Spirit. Graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, on whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of." grace, that the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, and the way the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ, for the kingdom, the power, and the glory of yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I give you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Body of Christ.
that being the food of charity, it may confirm our hearts and steer us to serve you in our nation through Christ our Lord. Please be seated for the announcements. This weekend's second collection is for St. Vincent de Paul. Next second collection, next weekend, is for the Catholic University of America and Catholic Communications. Thank you so much for your kindness and support. RCMA session will start back on Thursday, September the 3rd. September the 3rd. Invite someone to attend class and renew the Catholic faith, or invite someone who is interested in becoming Catholic. See the bulletin for more details. Saturday morning's men's group will meet on September 12th from 7 to 8 a.m. at the Cathedral Center. We are honored to have our shepherd, Bishop Strickland, join this breakfast. Please take the recommended precautions, wearing your mask and other following all the protocols to maintain maintaining all the social distance and all requirements for meetings. Coffee, juice, snacks, and others will be provided. If you have any questions, please call Deacon Steve Curry, and the phone is in the bulletin. Bishop Corman is conducted as a sweep text list. To take this semester with all funds going to the school. The grand prize will be a brand new Ford F-150 truck or a new car. Or you can take $20,000 in cash. It's pretty good. So please follow this and support as much as you can. Tickets are only $5. More announcements in the bulletin. We would like to welcome Father Carlos Piedrahita to the Cathedral Parish. Father Carlos comes from the Archdiocese of Hartford. He will begin his ministry in the Cathedral on September the 1st. Father Carlos is a bilingual priest and he is very happy to be with us. Thank you for your attention. Please stand. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you for being here, celebrating the Holy Mass to all of you who serve. Thank you.